We investigate the case of the mysterious disappearing websites on this episode of Fact or Fiction. We're back with Fact or Fiction. I'm Suyash Barve, and with me as always is Jensi Jacob from Boom. Hi Jensi.
Hi Suyash.
Alright, so Jensi, a couple of websites popped up during the Karnataka elections. Boom was apparently tracking them. Yeah. You guys were on the case as it began. These websites were spreading fake news.
Yes.
Right? And now they appear to have disappeared.
Right.
Jensi, what's the story?
So it's very interesting. We have tracked down five such websites. One is called Bengaluru Times. Now, this was a website which is putting out various right-wing propaganda.
By the way, 10 on 10 for legit-sounding website.
Right. Bengaluru Times, right?
Yeah.
And they were putting out all kind of propaganda saying that, you know, that Congress and JDS is supporting the Muslim community, going to come out with various, you know, swaps for them. What about the Hindu community? These were the kind of stories they were putting out. Now, when you go and check, you know, when you go and click that URL, you'll find that it has become a paying guest accommodation website called Mia Rooms.
Quite a turnaround, yeah.
Yes.
So, quite a switch in business model for the Bengaluru Times.
And but, you know, just a caveat here. In fact, we spoke to the founder of Mia Rooms, and he says, and I genuinely want to believe that he's right, he says that his co-founder bought this domain about you know, a week back from GoDaddy. And they had no clue that this website had another political past, in, you know, or a news website past. So, you know, let's take them out on face value for that. You know?
I figured he'd just say that journalism doesn't pay very well anymore.
Right. So, whatever. You know, right now, it's called Mia Rooms.
Right.
You know, apart from that, there are several other websites like Bengaluru Mirror, there is Express Bangalore, and there is Voice of Bengaluru. If you see that all of these websites had some connection with probably credible news publications.
All so trying to sound like credible.
Sound like that.
Almost, just about there.
And they were spreading. What were they doing? They were up to during the month of March. So all of these websites came into existence in the month of March. That's very interesting to note.
Right.
And we had the elections in the month of May. And all of them were putting out fake surveys. They were putting out similar sounding surveys from credible poll agencies. Then they were saying that BJP is going to win, or they're going to come out with various numbers. And they were saying that these are the constituencies where BJP is going to win. So various stuff they were coming out with. And what I would like to say here is that all these websites were pro-BJP websites. Now, that's the interesting part that you need to note here. And right now, when you look at it, all the URLs are dead, except for the one that I'm talking about. All the URLs are dead. You don't have a single of them. So you can't even make out, apart from going into our old stories, archival stories, that what were the kind of stories they were putting out. And right now, if you go and click, either the site doesn't load or the URLs are dead.
Let's call this what it is, Jensi. This is a strategy. There's clearly a plan behind this to put up these websites at a certain time, right around the elections. And it's really scary, isn't it? Like these kind of things can crop up on every election now.
Right. So, which is what we've been doing during the election coverage, that we were looking at these websites and surprisingly, all these websites had good traffic. You know, most of them, their content was on WhatsApp. They were on Facebook.
Right.
They were on Twitter. People were sharing it on Facebook. In fact, even on Facebook, there is a Karnataka election update page, which is still existing. And that page was sharing all these websites. You know, that was a common link to all these websites. Unfortunately, we have not been able to track them down because they've done a good job to hide their identity or who is running them. But at the end of the day, we can at least say that when you get the stories from credible, non-credible links, you need to be sure why you're clicking it and why you're reading it. You know,
right.
This is exactly the reason why you should not do that, because after their utility is done, you know, they will disappear.
Journalism may not be dead, but these fake news websites sure are. Log on to boomlife.in for more coverage on this story. And rest assured, we'll be keeping a close eye on election coverage and fake news websites like these when they come up. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next time.